In this illustration, we'll analyze the shape of a liquid surface in a rotating vessel. We are given that in a cylindrical vessel, a liquid is filled partially and it is rotated at constant angular speed omega. And it is saying if liquid also rotates along with the vessel, it is seen that near to side walls, liquid rises up as shown in the figure. And we are required to find the shape y equals to f of x of the surface with respect to origin at the lowest point O. Now, to analyze it, we can consider a particle of liquid on the surface in the rotating vessel. Here, say if this is the shape, I am redrawing the figure, and we consider this as x direction and this as y direction. And the vessel is rotating at angular speed omega. Now, if I consider a particle on the surface of this liquid, then it will be revolving in a circular path, say of radius x. This point, if having coordinate x comma y, in this situation we can consider this would be revolving in a circle of radius x. The particle would be experiencing an outward centrifugal force in the frame of this container as m omega square x. And this will experience a downward force mg, which is balanced by the normal reaction onto the particle due to the layer of liquid beneath it. Now, in this situation, if we draw a tangent of this point along this curve, then we can say if a slope of this tangent is theta, here we can see with the vertical normal reaction is also making an angle theta. And we can write, if this particle is P, we can write as shown in figure, for equilibrium of particle P in frame of container, we use, here we can write n sin theta is equals to m omega square x and n cos theta is equals to mg. And from these relations, if this first equation, this second equation, then 1 by 2 will result tan theta that is equals to omega square x by g. And in this curve, we can write down the slope tan theta as dy by dx for this curve, which is omega square x by g. And here we can write dy is equals to omega square x by g dx. And if we integrate it at point O, x was 0, y was 0, and at point P, x and y are the coordinates. So this will result as the integration y is equals to omega square x square by 2g. That is the equation of the shape of the curve obtained due to rotation of this fluid. That is the result of this problem. The same result you can also obtain by using Bernoulli's theorem for the rotating fluid in ground frame. So I'm leaving it as an exercise for you to evaluate the same result by using Bernoulli's theorem for the rotating fluid in ground frame.